Now, we're picking information that a number of bookings for Christmas have been cancelled following the announcement of the mandatory vaccination directive at the International Airport. Let's bring in President of the Hotels Association, Dr. Edward Akanyamike, on this development story. We're grateful, sir, that you could join us. Explain to us the scale of impacts the vaccination mandate is having on the hotels industry just a few days, you know, after we did hear of this new directive at the Kutuka International Airport.
Well, thank you very much, Charles, for the opportunity. Let me put it this way. You know, the measures that the Ghana is putting in place to check the spread of the Omicron virus, it's similar to what other countries are doing. The emphasis or focus is on tightening the entry into the country. And so certainly it will affect international visits into the country and consequently on occupancy. I must say that we are yet to get the exact figures involved. But we also have to look at it from the perspective of the domestic tourism, which we have been preaching or talking about in recent times. Because indeed, immediately the WHO announced the detection of the Omicron virus, we anticipated that such cancellations will happen. We anticipated that these are the challenges that we will be facing. Albeit, we also know that we have some hardcore tourists who may have planned far ahead of this and will still want to take that post of still coming to the country, going by all the protocols that are put in place. So we are placing some faith and hope in that. But the domestic tourism promotion is also something that a lot of the operators are placing emphasis on. So all things being equal, I don't believe that in this short term, the impact on the industry will be as grave as we are anticipating.
Well, but of course, this is a peak season, actually, for the hotels industry. December, the month of December, when we're seeing most of these international travelers troop into the country to have a feel of tourism here. But we now do have the vaccine mandate, and as you rightly stated, it's, you know, emanating in some cancellations. But help us appreciate the concerns of industry players on this vaccine mandate, because, mind you, we're not having vaccine mandates across, you know, the world. It's not in the United States, actually, because you need, you know, verification of COVID vaccination, the card. If you don't have that, you should have a negative PCR test. You're not mandated. You won't be subjected to, you know, having to take a dose of a vaccine at the airport. This is a unique situation here in Ghana. So what exactly are industry players telling you as president of the Hotels Association?
Well, we also need to balance health with business as well. Much as we want to do business and take advantage of the digitized, we don't have to do that at the expense of our health, because if we all end up dying from the virus, we wouldn't have even any business to talk about. Having said that, we appreciate what the health service and the government is doing with regards to controlling the entrance into the country with regards to the virus. And for us, it is something that we expected immediately the Omicron was announced. It is something that we knew that the government would go that far because of our experience over the past 2 years.
All right.
And indeed, we continue to put our protocols and measures in place. And so we are not really concerned to the extent that we will have healthy people entering into our country to enjoy the services that we provide, rather to plead for the borders to be loose and people to enter and create health challenges for us.
All right, great. But of course, we're picking from your submission that there's going to be much focus on domestic tourism as against the over-reliance in, you know, recent past on international travelers. How are you going to ensure the sustainability of this direction?
Well, we have started with a lot of collaborations going on, the various trade associations, the various business in the tourism chain are now coming together to form all kinds of partnership to ensure that the Ghanaian or the people in the country take some interest in domestic tourism, and also to also ensure that the various programs that the Ministry of Tourism, Arts and Culture, and indeed the Ghana Tourism Authority has put in place with regards to the Zimba Engage. That's not to say that we are discouraging any international visits, but people in Ghana can also enjoy the Zimba Engage, much as the international visitors will also enjoy it. So we are also pushing and focusing on these events that is being promoted for the Ghanaian to also enjoy it. And then those who are able to join us from outside, why not? We'll all enjoy it in good health. So, and of course, the e-marketing is going on. There's so much online presence, social media presence. The various tourism trade associations are using all those channels to ensure that the people move around, of course, observing the protocols so that we all stay alive and enjoy the Christmas.
All right. Just before I let you go, Dr. Edward Namike, the elephant in the room has to do with the cost involved in accessing, you know, the hotels industry in Ghana. Domestic tourists often raise this matter. Now we're in the festive season, you know, and you're the president of the association. Any assurance related to cost? Are we going to be seeing discounts this time around in this festive season at various hotels?
Charles, I have always said that, you see, hotels in Ghana range from budgets, 1-star, 2-star, to 5-star hotels.
Yes.
Let's cut our coats according to our sizes. Now, if...
Here's a case where you want to bring in more domestic, you know, consumers to have a feel of the products that you have.
I was coming to that point. But first of all, let's appreciate that we have various hotel categories for various pockets.
Okay.
Okay, that needs to be, because we have very good budget 1-star and 2-star facilities in the country, spread across the country, which domestic tourists can take advantage of. Now, that aside, we also want to assure our patrons and customers that, see, don't always focus on the rack rates. Don't always focus on what you see on the websites or even at the hotels. Talk to the hotels. If you have a number of people who are visiting a particular hotel, call them and talk to them and arrange something. They will give you a good package. Okay? The rates are not cast in stone. Based on their occupancy, based on the situation, they can give good packages to the our patrons. So we should not stop at the rates we see on the websites or being advertised. Let's talk to the hotels, and they will give us something that I believe we'll appreciate, and that will fit our pockets as well.
You've been diplomatic with the answer, but of course we appreciate you, Dr. Edward Aka Nyamike, the president of the Hotels Association. That's how we end this edition of Marketplace. Of course, for more news, please log on to myjoyonline.com. Many thanks for watching. Enjoy the rest of our bulletins.